Hey my friends, welcome back. As you can see, today we got pretty tiny. We do a very small landscape painting study. Yeah, we start by a quick underpainting, as you can see here. Very straightforward, just a few base colors, more or less. Very thick color. Then we let the whole thing dry and yeah. And I start to build up the next layer, as you can see here. I already started to build up this layer, as you can see here, and to show you how it's done, more or less. I said before, the background layer is completely dry. Make sure that it is really bone dry, so that the next layer of color is not lifting off the first layer. There are a couple of things I would like to teach you here. First thing is we have the outskirts of this cloud here, this cloud body. A lot of people do it wrong. They paint clouds like they were cut out. They don't do this fuzzy, edgy thing, this dry brush blending. The clouds. As you can see here, we have areas that basically fade away, more or less. And these are really essential for realistic cloud painting. Next thing is we have very subtle color differences. As you can see here, we have this slightly bit lighter grayish color in this area here. Maybe you've seen this circle thing here. And it's another thing that people do wrong. They tend to paint clouds flat, and you need and you want to have those very subtle, very small differences to make this cloud body become 3D. And you see this bit lighter color here is very, it's just a hint lighter, and this is enough to give the impression of this volume that we have here. You see here this color here is darker, these areas are a bit lighter, and but just a hint in these areas, and this is enough to flesh out this cloud body more or less. The next thing is you should use for this kind of way of building up clouds a very thick color. I'm using here the water mixable oils, and they are not thinned down at all. I think I used perhaps just one drop of linseed oil to give them just a little bit of a better flow. But overall they are really very thick, and this helps to really get this blue of the background covered very nice and very thick, very in a way that we don't have to worry about applying another layer of color. The next important thing is that of course building a volume is important. That's what I'm doing here. As you can see, I'm taking my time blending those colors to really make it look bubbly and 3D. And this takes a while, as you can see here. And then comes the important lesson here. Lower end, grab a clean brush and start to rub this fresh color here into the dry color we have in the background. And this basically lets the cloud emerge from the background, as you can see here. And this is something that I see people doing wrong all the time. They paint clouds like they were cut out. And not just the lighter areas, but also the darker areas. And this is something that clouds really do have. They have parts of their bodies that really emerge from the back and do this just by rubbing in the flesh color into the dry background. A time lapse of how I build up other cloud bodies. This painting here. Can you see again? Dark color. It's kind of a base, and then the lighter color around it, in the middle of it. Yeah, and then we start to paint the bushes here. Greens. We have kind of this stingy leaf character here. Apparently a kind of a tropical beach, and what I do here is I go in with the dark color first and establish these dark patches here, and then I go a bit lighter the screen here, as you can see, and start to build up those details of those leaves that we have in the front of these darker areas. And you see, we have also this kind of brownish color here on the right side that I use to apply other details. And really make sure to make it random, make it look. These bushes are not cut every other week. They just look as they grow, more or less. you need also to be in control of the thickness of the color. We have lots of thinner colors, so that we can use the underpainting a lot. Same goes for this area here. I'm just blending over thin layer of color to just rework those sand areas here. And then we start to add a ton of details, as you can see here. Again, very thin down color. Also having color variations, lighter, darker areas. It needs to have some blending effect to it. So go back with a very clean brush and just level it out a little bit. And then I decided to go away from the reference photo and build up some water, some thin water here on this area of the beach, by just glazing this blue color over parts of this darker area here. Some lighter colors as well. And then I went back and added some more sticks and branches on the beach itself. There can't be enough details, in my opinion, even on such a small painting like this here. Yeah, then we're done. So that's it for today, but make sure before you leave that you check out one of these other two videos here.